Hello and welcome to 101 Labs. In today's lab, we'll learn how to configure AWS CLI for command line access. AWS CLI is a powerful tool that allows users to manage AWS resources from the command line, enabling automation and scripting capabilities. In this lab, we will install, configure, and verify the AWS CLI on our system. The first step to configure the CLI is to install the CLI. So let's start the lab and install the CLI. Click on this link and follow the instructions to download the AWS CLI version 2 installer for your operating system, Windows, Mac OS, or Linux. And now let's go to this web page. Since I have a Windows system, all the installation steps that we are going to perform are regarding the Windows operating system. However, Linux and Mac OS are listed here with proper instructions. So let's click on Windows. And here it says download and run AWS CLI MSI installer. So let's click on this link to download it. After the download is complete, we'll run the installer and follow the installation wizard to install AWS CLI. Now let's click on this file, and after that, we will click on OK. In the installation wizard, click Next, accept the terms, click Next, and then Next Install. After the installation is completed, click on Finish. Verify the installation by pressing the Windows key plus R and in the Run window type, CMD, and press Enter. So I'll press Windows plus R, type CMD, and press Enter, which will open the command prompt. Here I write AWS, dash dash version, and press Enter. If I see something like AWS dash CLI forward slash some version, that means AWS CLI is successfully installed. The next step is to configure the AWS CLI. Before configuration, we need the access keys for our admin user so we can make API calls to AWS using AWS CLI. To create these access keys from root account, go to IAM Users, Admin, and from the Summary tab, click on Create Access Key. So now I'll go to my root user account, and here from the admin user, I will press Create Access Key. Now I select Command Line Interface. Check this checkbox for confirmation and press Next. Here, I will give this key a description. And then press Create Access Keys. Remember, you should never share your access keys with anyone for any reason. We can download the CSV file to save these access keys somewhere safe. Since we now have AWS access keys, we can configure our AWS CLI to use them. To configure AWS CLI with these keys, we will run this command in our command prompt. So, I'll go to my command prompt and type AWS configure and press Enter. This will ask for my AWS access key. And now I provide my AWS secret access key. For the region, we would type US East 1, and for the output format, we will use JSON. Now, our AWS CLI is configured. The configuration settings that we just made are stored in two files, config and credentials under your username in a folder, .aws. Now I'm in my .aws folder under my username, and I have two files, config and credentials. If I open these two files using a text editor, I will see in config file, we have the information regarding the region and output. And in the credential file, I will have the information about my AWS access key and AWS secret access key. We didn't provide a profile name while configuring the AWS CLI profile, so our profile name is set to default. When we run any AWS CLI command without providing a profile name, it will use this default profile of our admin user, and this is dangerous and can result in unexpected outputs. If we run the command AWS IAM list users, and then we press enter, AWS CLI will use the credentials of my admin user since it is the only and the default profile currently available. It returns the list of the users to us. Since we currently only have one user, we will only have one array of users. Using the default profile or running AWS CLI commands without specifying a profile can cause unintended outcomes, such as creating resources under the wrong user. To prevent this, it is recommended to assign meaningful names to our profiles and avoid using the default profile. To create a named profile, we would use a command AWS configure --profile and the profile name. So now I'll type AWS configure --profile and provide it a profile name, like AWS 101 Labs Admin, and press enter. Here I have to provide the access key again, the secret access key, the region name, and the output format. Now we have created a named profile with the name AWS 101 Labs Admin. If we go back to our config and credential files, we will see that now we have another profile, AWS 101 Labs Admin, with its own credentials and own configurations. If I type AWS configure list profiles and press enter, I will see we currently have two profiles. Unfortunately, there is no way to remove AWS CLI profiles from the command prompt, so we have to remove the default profile manually. For this purpose, we will go to Config and Credential Files and remove the default profile from here, from the Config and Credential file. Now we only have the profile AWS 101 Labs Admin. If I run the same command again and press Enter, I will only have one profile. If I try to run the command AWS IAM list users now, this command will fail because we do not have any default profile to use. So now we have to provide the profile name that you want to use with this AWS CLI command. So you can see that when we provide the profile name with the valid credentials, it can run the AWS CLI commands. If you ever think that your AWS keys have been compromised, you can always delete them or you can deactivate them. Or if you're not planning to use those keys anymore, they can be deactivated. To delete the access keys, go to IAM Users Admin and Security Credentials, scroll down a bit, and find the Key Access tab. From the Actions drop-down, you can deactivate the key and delete the key. So, I'll go to IAM Users, Admin, and Security Credentials. Then I'll scroll down a little bit. And from the Access Key tab, I will press on Actions and click Deactivate. We cannot directly delete these keys because if we try to delete them, we'll have to deactivate them first. So, we'll click Deactivate and we'll copy the name of the key provided in this box and press Delete. I have successfully deleted these keys since they were already compromised because I showed them to you. So now if I go to my command prompt and I try to run any command, this command will fail because this profile does not have valid credentials anymore. And that's it for today's lab. For extended learning, you can click on this link to configure setting for the AWS CLI. Or to learn more about AWS CLI command references, you can click on this link. You can also learn how to use IAM roles in the AWS CLI by clicking on this link. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you liked it, and I'll see you next time.